The men who used to be strong in faith have turned their backs and has not and does not believe God anymore. I'm seeing where the people who were strong, they're falling away. The Bible talks about it that in the last days there'll be a falling away. And we've seen the falling away happening. And I'm here, glory to God, and my husband is here tonight to implore you, to beg you, let us pray. Amen. This 2013, maybe we didn't pray enough. Maybe we were doubting and we were not in faith. But tonight, the song and the trumpet has been sounded that we need to pray with supplication and prayer and intercession so that men, glory to God, will not faint.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So at this time, we invite you all to call in with whatever you have on your heart. Let us pray. Amen. This is the season, the song says, to be jolly. Amen. We know about the joy of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But we must pray. Amen.
Yes.
So tonight, we want to join with you all in faith and pray for whatever need there is. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We want to start it off tonight, glory to God, where the Bible says here in 1 Timothy 2 that we need to pray for kings and for all those that are in authority. So tonight we want to pray, glory to God. Father, we lift up, hallelujah, President Obama tonight. Lord, we pray tonight in the mighty name of Jesus that, Lord, you will touch his heart, that you will touch him, Lord, from the crown of his head. Your Holy Spirit will rest upon him, oh God. I pray right now, Lord, that your Spirit will move in this man. Lord, that you will save this man tonight. Lord, we pray forth, hallelujah, your angels to encamp around him. Lord, we pray, God, right now that every fiery dart of the enemy, Lord, that you will quench it by the fire of the Holy Ghost tonight. I pray tonight, Lord, in the name of Jesus, as you're listening, people, oh God, touch and agree that he's protected, that you will make right decisions. Lord, I pray that you will address everything that need to be addressed concerning the people of God. Lord, that there will be victory, oh God, through this man. Hallelujah for the people of God. Lord, we bless your name tonight. And we decree and we declare tonight that it is so, that it is done. Glory to God in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says that we may live, when we pray, that we may lead a quiet and peaceful life in godliness and honesty. Hallelujah. So many of us are living a life that is not peaceful. We're living a life that is not godly. We're living a life, glory to God, that is not honest. Glory to God. We have people who are blood washed. We have people who say that they're saved, yet it's okay for them to lie. Yet it's okay for them to go to the club Saturday nights and then come in church on Sunday mornings. Listen to me, people of God. It is time for us to take a stand and let God be God. And let the truth stand forever through Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We're just giving you a few scriptures. Amen. We want to look at Ephesians 6, 18 to 20. Praise the name of the Lord. We have to pray. We have to pray, church. We have to pray, people of God, because prayer is the only thing, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
that will change things for us.
Ephesians 6 and verses 18 to 20. It says, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints, And for me, Paul says, that utterance may be given to me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains, that in it I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Paul is asking for prayer, and we are also asking for prayer, that we may speak boldly. Amen. Reverend Dr. Sandra Baptiste is asking for prayer, and Reverend Dr. Jimmy Baptiste is asking, we are asking for prayer that we may speak boldly.
Yes.
Amen. During the course of our time on this radio station, we have spoken boldly.
Yes.
And you may think that everyone enjoys or likes or agrees with what we have to say, but it isn't always like that. Hallelujah. The enemy is always at hand.
Yes.
To stop the work of God. Amen. As we said before, if a preacher comes along and he speaks about all the good things that God will do for you all, everything is prosperity. Amen. He will have a following.
Oh, yes.
Amen. But we see in the Bible from the Old to the New Testament that the people who spoke truth uncompromised according to what God said, when God said, go and say this to the people.
Mm-hmm,
amen.
Mm-hmm.
The great prophets were always rejected.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
When Christ came, hallelujah, yes, on the scene, he was utterly rejected.
Yes.
Utterly. Amen.
Yes.
And when we come, amen, hallelujah, to speak, thus said the Lord, not everybody agrees.
Mm-hmm,
hallelujah. Mm-hmm. But thanks be to God.
Yes.
We have come for, if it's just one soul,
yes,
to bring revelation, to bring salvation through Jesus Christ, amen, to bring some breakthrough to just one soul. If this time that we've spent here, amen, one soul got their breakthrough, then it was worth it.
Amen.
Because, you see, we do not labor and pray and intercede for people, amen, hallelujah, for our own boasting.
Hello.
But we do it because we know that we were once, amen, in need of, yes, a Savior.
Amen, amen.
And when we found that Savior, and he told us, go forth into all the world,
yes,
amen,
yes,
and preach ye this gospel, amen, in Jerusalem, in Judea, and in the uttermost part of the world.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
He says, go in the highways
and the,
and the byways.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And bring in the sick, the maimed,
yes,
the poor. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So if we, in our programs here, hallelujah, touch one soul.
Yes.
Open one eye, bring clarification to one person. Mm-hmm. Amen. It was worth it. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So tonight we're here. We're making prayers and supplication. We want you to join with us in faith.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because the Bible says that where two or three are gathered together,
mm-hmm,
in his name.
In his name.
Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
Mind you now, a lot of people sometimes they gather in the bishop's name.
Hello.
They gather in the apostle's name.
Mm-hmm.
And you hear it out of the mouth. The apostle said.
Yes.
The bishop said.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
But the Bible said.
Hello.
In his name.
In his name.
If we are gathered together. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
There he is.
And mind you, that two or three, amen, in the two or the three, in that number, the Holy Spirit is always present.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
So tonight, come on, join with us. Call him for whatever you need prayers for. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Saints, I want to throw this out to you. Amen. This walk that we walk here, amen, it's a very, very serious walk.
Mm.
The Bible says that we wrestle not against flesh and blood.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. But darkness has entered men's heart.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
And sometimes the one that you think, amen, is so close to you, will always have your back, is the one who allows Satan to enter into his heart.
Yes.
And when they see the good work that you're doing for our soon coming King, His name is Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
The devil finds opportunity in them to try and destroy you.
Yes, yes.
We must pray.
Must.
Because in Romans it says, sometimes we do not know what we ought to pray for.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But with groanings and supplications. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Caller, you're on the air. Hallelujah. Caller, you're on the air.
Hello, hello.
Hello.
Good night, Pastor Baptist.
Good night.
Yes, good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Yes, yes, I am calling to let you know that although many may be not, you know, accepted by the scripture or the message that you take out, you know, there are a few. And I am one of them.
Amen.
And to let you know that I am well satisfied and blessed.
Hallelujah.
The other night you came last week, I was a little late to call you.
Mm-hmm.
And to let you know how much I am blessed with your words, you and your wife.
Amen.
You know, I am very, very glad to hear you. And when I go on my knees in my prayer, you people, not only you, the both of you, but all of the Bible, the gospel workers,
amen,
I put them before the presence of God.
Hallelujah.
And I told the Lord, I said, Lord God, I thank you for them.
Amen.
Bless them. I ask you the strength for you people, because I'm very, very glad to hear you.
Amen.
I am satisfied of hearing the word of God.
Hallelujah.
I am satisfied. And all what you are saying and your wife is saying, that's I'm here saying, oh, that is true. That is true. And then, you know, the Spirit of God is around. When you people speak the word, you know, I am lifted.
Hallelujah.
I am lifted.
Amen.
In grace.
Hallelujah.
You know, so I'm thankful for you people very much, very much. May God ever bless you. And before you leave, I'm wishing you a happy Christ Day, not Christmas Day.
Amen.
Christ Day.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Thank
praise
you.
The Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I'm thankful to hear you people.
Thank
God
you.
Bless you.
Bless you. Bless you too, sis. Thank you so much.
Yes.
God bless you too.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And happy Christ Day to you too. We appreciate your encouragement, because we also need encouragement. Amen. When God has put a mantle upon you and he has given you a vision to walk in your calling. Amen. Sometimes the load gets very heavy, but as leaders as people who know that we are responsible, amen, for the souls of others. Because once you take up this calling, amen, or you walk in this calling where you start to speak the gospel and you start feeding into people's life and you start to see growth, you have a responsibility. And the devil, amen, who is defeated, hallelujah.
Yes.
He doesn't target people that is not a threat to him.
Amen.
So what we're saying, and we're asking the saint to pray for us as we continue to pray for them, because it is not an easy thing. Amen. Paul had to go through. Jesus went through. And we will.
Amen.
Because we have to.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. No man, hallelujah, can go free. Everyone must take up their cross.
Mm-hmm.
But the beauty in this thing is that if we bound together, as the Bible says, one faith, one God, one Lord, and one baptism. Amen. If the saints are binded together in one spirit, amen, then the walk will be easy.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. It brings me to a thought that I had the other day when I said that The sun and the moon doesn't compete with each other.
Amen.
The sun has its own activity going on where it have its purpose.
Amen.
Where it shines in the daytime to show light upon the world.
Yes.
And then the moon comes down at night when the sun goes out. And it keeps the atmosphere and the area lit so that man wouldn't fall and be in darkness.
Amen.
Because a lot of us think that is the street lights that are giving us light. Really, it's not true. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Because if God should remove the moon at night, the street light wouldn't be enough to light the world.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So the moon doesn't compete with the sun.
Hallelujah.
Because each one has its purpose
and its place.
And its place.
Amen.
So they don't compete with each other.
Hallelujah.
But they complete each other.
Amen.
And it should be the same in the body of Christ, where we should have one purpose. And that is to pray, that is to intercede and join hands and faith with each other to fight and to fight a good fight of faith.
Yes.
Glory, not to fight the devil.
Yes.
Because if we fight the devil, we're going to lose.
Amen.
But to fight a good fight of faith, because hear what? The devil is a defeated foe.
He's already defeated.
He's already defeated. And he's moving about as if he's something.
Yeah.
Glory to God. But our big brother Jesus have already defeated him.
Amen.
And he has already given us the word where he says we need to bind him. Amen.
Hallelujah.
So if we get together, Pastor, if we get together and we join faith and we join hands together and we have one in the body of Christ who has a problem and we pray and we intercede for that one person. Listen, in a second, I believe, because of the amount of faith that everybody has, even somebody with a little bit of faith, but when you join with somebody, the faith becomes big.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Everybody will get their deliverance.
That's right.
But what has happened, glory to God, and this situation with the pastors, it really troubled my soul. When men of God, I'm talking about bishops and apostles, pastors, men that leading people could commit suicide and don't even think about going to hell. We in trouble.
Hallelujah.
People of God, we need to get together and pray. We need to know this word inside out, not on a surface level, but in depth. So when situations come up, we'll be able to pull a word. We'll be able to call somebody to pray us through if we're too weak.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are at a time, glory to God, around this time, there's so much sadness. Because some people have their families in different areas of the Caribbean. And they have their families in different areas of the world. And they can, some people can't travel. And they're sad because everybody has their families and they're all alone in the nighttime. They come from work and they lay in the house and they're miserable. Some of these people need to be in a place where they could call somebody and say, you know what? I'm feeling really sad tonight. And I just need you to pray my strength in the Lord. But what happens a lot of times, if you take a chance to call somebody, they will tell you you don't have faith. You see, when somebody call you to tell you about how they're feeling, they don't expect you to tell them you don't have faith. They just want you to listen and tell them, listen, God is able.
Amen.
And he will come through for you at some point. So be encouraged. I got you.
Hallelujah.
I got you. I have a little bit of food in my house. I'm going to share some with you. Glory to God. I have a little money. I'm going to put something in your hand.
Amen.
But we've become so selfish in the house of God, in the body of Christ, that we can't even pray one for the other. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Prayers and supplication, Paul says, that men should be praying all times without doubting. Hallelujah. Tonight we are here once again, as we said, to join with you in faith, to pray for you, for your family, for your loved ones, for your lost ones. Amen. for your sick ones, for your weak ones. Hallelujah. We all have some issue in our lives.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Some of us have issues in our bodies.
Yes.
We're here to pray for you. If you need prayer tonight, we're here and we're available to pray with you in faith. And the fervent, effective prayer of a righteous man, the Bible says, availeth much. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus said, before you bring the next scripture, Jesus said that a house divided cannot stand. Hallelujah. He's saying unity. That's what he's saying. He's saying singleness of mind. Hallelujah. He's saying singleness of purpose. Hallelujah. Because the Bible says that it is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. They are all united in one.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
So we also, who have this mind in us as Christ Jesus, amen, we have the mind of Christ, so we must exercise the authority and the activities of his life.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You know, some people, Pastor, they're walking around without hope. And I'm not even talking about the unbeliever. I'm talking about the believers, the Amen. Saints.
Amen.
But tonight, in the book of Psalms, Psalms 31, if you could read, glory to God. Psalms 31.
Hallelujah.
From 21. Well, let's read from 20.
Mm-hmm. Psalms 31, verses 22.
To the end, to 24.
Amen. Psalms 31, verses 20 to 34. And it says, you shall hide them in the secret place of your presence from the plots of man.
Mm-hmm.
You shall keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues.
Mm-hmm.
Blessed be the Lord, for he has shown me his marvelous kindness in a strong city. For I said in my haste, I am cut off from before your eyes. Nevertheless, you heard the voice of my supplications when I cried out to you.
Jesus.
Oh, love me, oh, love the Lord, all you his saints. For the Lord preserves the faithful
yes.
and fully repays the proud person.
Mm-hmm.
Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart, all you who hope in the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
The psalmist says here, David, he said, God will hide us in the secret of his presence.
Amen.
From the presence of the pride of man. And we know what the pride of man is.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He said he shall keep us secretly in a pavilion
mm-hmm.
from the strife of tongues.
Amen. From the strife of tongues. So strife begins in the tongue.
Jesus.
In the New Testament, it says that it is the instrument that sets on fire the course of hell.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
The tongue.
Mm-hmm.
And then it says again that in the tongue lays life and death.
Yes.
So the power of life and death lies in the tongue.
Amen.
So that is why we're saying that when saints don't unite together,
mm-hmm.
amen, and we make the mistake and we speak what is not in the Bible, what mm-hmm, is not mm-hmm, of God,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
amen, and we go into speaking against one another
mm-hmm.
for whatever reason, that's where the strife begins.
Yes.
But you see, it gives the devil opportunity, because now we open a door and give him legal right to attack the brethren.
Amen.
And we don't understand spiritual protocol when we operate like that.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes.
When we think that we just, you know, we just venting and I need to get it off my chest.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
amen.
Mm-hmm.
Or you think you're justified in saying things against the brethren. Hallelujah. You might feel justified, but that doesn't justify what you're saying.
Yes.
Amen. Because Amen. What it does now is that it gives the evil one ammunition and fodder to build a case against the one that you're speaking against. Hallelujah. And then it gives him the opportunity to mount an attack.
My God.
And he doesn't only attack the person that you're speaking against, he attacks you also.
Yes, yes.
Because it began with you.
It began with you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, in Psalms, it speaks about the tongues and strife, and that is where strife begins.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, yes.
With words. Hallelujah.
But go ahead.
So, that is why we're here tonight, to join together with those of you over the airwaves, because Paul asks for prayer and supplication.
Yes.
We all see Paul as the greatest apostle.
Yes.
Amen. Even he was very weak at times.
Yes.
Amen. He spoke about perils with brethren.
My God.
He spoke about being in danger.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Not only with the people in the world, but with his own brother.
Yes.
In the Old Testament, the prophecy of Christ, he said, my brother who ate with me, he has lifted up his heel against me.
Yes.
The one who ate my bread.
Amen.
So we're not ignorant of the devil's devices. We're here today, amen, to strengthen one another. Because as we know that we need strength from you, we know that you need strength from us.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So please call in with whatever your issue, and we will join in faith with you. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. But one of the things is that God always leaves us with a solution.
Amen.
He never leaves us hanging.
That's right.
Where we have a situation, he always put it in his word.
Mm-hmm.
He says he's going to do this because this is being done.
Yes.
And he says he's going to put things in place. Glory to God. He says, because in verse 23, he said, the second part, he said, for the Lord preserves the faithful.
Yes.
And plentifully rewards the proud doer.
Hey.
So hear what? God is giving 100-fold to the faithful.
Yes.
But he's also giving 100-fold to the proud doer.
According to their work.
Hello.
Amen.
So if you do evil, you're going to get rewarded 100-fold from God. Not man.
Hallelujah.
But from God.
Amen.
But if you stay faithful and you do good, God will. God will. I say God will. Somebody, God will.
Yes.
God will reward you.
Amen.
Because you've been faithful.
Because the word says he's faithful and he's just.
And he's just.
Hallelujah.
There's no one just in him.
Amen.
There's no fault in God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. So we want to look at 1 Peter. Hallelujah. So call in. This is Choice Radio. And the number is 347-663-8638. That's Choice Radio. It's your life and your salvation and your choice tonight. Glory to God. 347-663-8638. And we're going to read 1 Peter 4. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. We thank God for victory tonight.
Amen.
We thank God that we have the victory. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
We want to read 1 Peter 4.
Uh-huh.
Let's read from 7 to 9.
Amen. 1 Peter.
Oh, let's read 7 to 10.
Amen. 1 Peter 4 and verses 7 to 10. It says, but the end of all things is at hand. Therefore, be serious and watchful in your prayers. And above all things, have fervent love for one another. For love will cover a multitude of sins. Be hospitable to one another without grumbling. As each one has received a gift, minister it to one another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. If anyone speaks, let him speak as the oracles of God. If anyone ministers, let him do it as with the ability which God supplies, that in all things God may be glorified through Jesus Christ, to whom belong the glory and the dominion forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
He said the end of all things are at hand.
Amen.
What is he saying? What is Peter saying? What is the apostle saying here?
Hallelujah.
He's saying that the time is drawing close.
All things are about to conclude.
Amen.
Amen.
So if all things, as he says here in the book, are about to conclude, my book says, my own says, to be therefore sober.
Mm-hmm.
It means that you have to have a clear head right now in this time.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And watch unto prayer.
Yeah.
So that means you need to have a clear mind. You need not to be drunk with wine and all the different things that are happening in your life.
Hmm.
And you need to be praying.
Amen.
You know, every church that I know calls a prayer and fast the beginning of every year.
Amen. Hallelujah.
The beginning, the first week of every year.
Mm-hmm.
A prayer and a fast is called sometimes 7 days, 21 days. Some even go as far as 40 days.
Mm-hmm.
But then at the end of that year, nobody could say what that fasting did for them during the year.
Amen.
Because you see, this thing needs to be a continual thing.
Hallelujah.
We can't just fast the first week and not fast the second month. Glory to God. Because you see, the devil, that slothful one, is as a roaring lion. He's seeking. When he went before God concerning Job, God asked him, where was he? Not that God didn't know.
Mm-hmm.
He said, I was walking to and fro, back and forth. He's looking.
Mm-hmm.
He's seeking. He's watching to see who move, who's speaking, what they're doing, so he could come in.
Yes.
So if the devil is moving about continually, why are we as saints of God not praying continually?
Mm-hmm.
Why are we only praying when a situation comes up?
Hallelujah.
Why are we praying, glory to God, when we have trouble in our lives?
Amen.
Some people, they get a deliverance when they pray, and then they forgot that they need to continue praying even more.
Amen.
When God brings them through. So what God is saying here is that we need to be sober at all times. And we need to be watchful. We need to watch. We need to pray. Hallelujah. And if we put on the love of Christ, if we show the love, the agape love,
yes,
the love for the brethren, the love even for the man in the world,
mm-hmm,
if we really, really get sold out with that love, then it's going to be easier, hallelujah, to even minister this word to the unsaved.
Hallelujah.
It's going to be even easier that when we stand before the Lord and we say, Father, we need help, he's going to show up.
Amen.
Because God is love. God, the whole essence of God is love. The whole essence of the Holy Spirit with Jesus is love.
Hallelujah.
So if we put on, he says, put on like we put our clothes on. You know, we put our clothes on and it fits us nicely.
Mm-hmm.
So if we put our love, if we put on the agape love of God on, then there is no way that when we pray and we intercede that God wouldn't answer.
Hallelujah. Amen. In prayers and supplication. The reason why Paul strictly warns us is I won't say that it was a request, it's a warning. Amen. To be always in prayer and supplications, because sometimes when we pray and we get our breakthrough, amen, there is always a counterattack.
Yes.
And the saints must understand that just because you had a breakthrough today, it doesn't mean that the wicked one is not waiting around the corner to attack again.
Mm.
But when we get our breakthrough, we have to know that we have to pray a little bit more. Amen. After the breakthrough.
Amen.
So that we can keep, amen, our blessing, so that we can keep, hallelujah, what we got from the breakthrough. Because if then we relax, amen, the attack, amen, that does come stronger will overtake us.
Amen.
That is why he said, be sober and be watchful. Amen. To this end. Hallelujah. Because even though Christ has already won the victory, glory be to God, we have to do our part. Amen. You know, I was examining something and I saw that one of the reasons why Christ, he would not allow a lot of people to follow him after he had given them the breakthrough, after they had a personal encounter with him. He would not allow them to follow him.
Yes.
Because Christ recognized that if he allowed them to follow him, that he would become a crutch.
All right.
So a lot of people just wanted to be close to Christ so they could prop on him, so that they wouldn't have to grow in faith.
Amen.
They wouldn't have to go through, and face some things, some life situations for themselves. So they wanted to be right there with him.
Yes.
So anything, they could just run to him. The demoniac from Gadara, he said, listen, go home to your family.
Yes, yes.
This is one of the worst case in the Bible. And when you look at it, you might ask yourself, but how come Christ didn't allow the man to walk with him? No, because Christ knew that the depths the man came from, he needed to go through. Amen. Some personal growth. So what I'm saying is this. God designed it that when the saints come into Christ, amen, that we, even though Christ is there with us, amen,
yes.
I'm talking about the personal aspect when he was on this earth. He didn't allow people, a lot of people, to directly walk with him.
Yes.
Because he didn't want to be a crutch.
Yes.
We have to know that is the same principle that applies, even though he says, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. But you have to know that you have to go through some personal growth in him.
Yes.
In order for you to stand up in faith.
Yes.
Because if he doesn't allow you to go through that, then it's difficult for you to exercise faith.
Amen.
Because we all must be tested.
Yes.
And no one is teaching us that how to be strong.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But in prayers and supplication together, we can be strengthened.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Yes.
So this is Choice Radio calling. Hallelujah. Christ is here with us and he's there with you.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit is in us and he's also there in you.
Amen.
So when we join together in faith, whatever it will be that we're praying for, we stand in full confidence in Jesus Christ that he will give us the answer.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. You know, on Thursday last, I went to get my results. I'd done some test results, some different tests. And when I went to the hospital, and the doctor was smiling, and she said, my goodness, I don't know what happened here, but I know that Jesus touched you. And I said, well, praise the Lord, doctor. And she said, yes, sir. She said, everything is good. And let me tell you something out in radio land. 2 years ago, I never gave this testimony, but I feel that it's coming to the end of the year, and I just want to encourage somebody. 2 years ago, I was diagnosed with full-blown diabetes. And 1 year later, because I had changed some things, so I became responsible, and God was able to work with me through Jesus Christ and my faith and my husband's faith. Amen. And they did the same test again 1 year after I became 50 pounds lighter. I did this test again and they could not find the diabetes. I'm here to tell somebody, last Thursday they had done the same test in August, because they want to make sure, glory to God, they did my eyes, they didn't find the diabetes. They did my blood, they didn't find the diabetes. They had said I had high cholesterol, right?
Yes.
Now the cholesterol has just been regulated for the longest while, and all they're saying is that my good cholesterol, I need to take a vitamin fish oil to bring it up a little more because it's a little too low. Listen to me, people of God. If we don't agree, I thank God for this man that God has given me over 24 years now.
Amen.
I thank God for this man who trusts God enough where when we, glory to God, join hands in faith, we pray and God hears and he answers the prayer. We have people who have testimonies about we believe in God with them, and their faith was strengthened.
Amen.
Amen. And they have a testimony that God came through for them.
Hallelujah.
What are you believing God for tonight? Glory to God. We have a new year coming up in the next week. What are you believing God for 2014? It's your life. It's your salvation. And it's your choice tonight to make. Because this is Choice Radio Call In. Glory to God. If you want to share a word, it's 347-663-8638. Glory to God on high.
Amen.
But we want to continue in the hope. Hallelujah. And if we could look at Titus 3, glory to God. Titus 3 talks about the eternal hope. The eternal hope and life in Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Titus 3.
Yeah, from 3 to 7.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I'll do from 3 to 8, because 8 gives you a nice thing. A nice conclusion.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
It says here, from verse 3 to
8. From 3 to 8.
Hallelujah. For we ourselves were also once foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving various lusts and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful and hating one another. But when the kindness and love of God our Savior toward man appeared, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us through the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us abundantly through Jesus Christ, our Savior, that having been justified by his grace, we should become heirs according to the hope of eternal life. This is a faithful saying, and these things I want you to affirm constantly, that those who have believed in God should be careful to maintain good works. These things are good and profitable to men. Amen.
Go ahead.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Now, the first thing I want to touch there, amen, just a sidebar, is that this is one of the scripture that says that Jesus is God.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Just for the Christian folks out there who might meet somebody and argue, why are you saying that Jesus is the Son of God or that he is God? Because if you look at the verse, it says God our Savior in verse 4. Okay? And then in verse 6, it says Jesus Christ our Savior.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
So he's saying that Jesus is God, our Savior.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So that's just a sidebar information.
Ooh, Jesus Hallelujah. Is God, our Savior. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But Paul says that this is a faithful saying, and these things I want you to affirm constantly.
Constantly.
What does he want us to affirm constantly?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Number one, that we have been saved.
Yes.
By Jesus Christ. Number two, that the Holy Spirit has been poured out upon us.
Amen.
Amen. And we must understand that when we come to pray and when we kneel down to make supplication for one another, uppermost in our mind, we must know where the standpoint that we're praying from.
Amen. Amen.
You must keep in mind that, listen, I'm a blood-washed saint.
Yes.
And also that I have the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Because the Bible says that Jesus said that when I go, I'll send another comforter. Amen. And he will teach us all things.
Yes.
That he dwells in us.
Yes.
God and Jesus dwells in us through the Holy Spirit who is in us.
Yes. Amen.
So these things we must maintain, amen, as saints.
Yes.
That is our power base. Let me put it that way.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So when we pray and we make supplications, we have to understand that we're coming from a point of power.
Amen.
A point of right. Because we have the right now.
Yes.
Because of Jesus Christ to go to the Father.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Caller, you're on the air.
Yes, good evening.
Amen.
I called to ask for prayer for my brother.
Amen.
He's really sick. He's diabetic. He can't eat, lost his appetite. and he can't sleep. He sleeps on a chair every night.
Mm-hmm.
He can't go to any doctor because they won't see him. The insurance money he had on the Medicaid is finished for the year.
Okay.
So he's really sick. Please, if you can help me pray for him.
Amen. Hallelujah. What's his name?
His name is Berto.
Say again?
Berto.
Berto, okay. Father in heaven, we thank you for giving us authority.
Hallelujah.
Through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Yes, Lord.
And his blood. Hallelujah. We thank you for washing us in his blood.
Yes, Lord.
Sanctifying us and setting us apart for your service and your pleasure.
Hallelujah.
We come now, Lord Jesus, as blood-washed saints and as your... Hallelujah. Father in heaven, your children, as Father in heaven, as your sons through Jesus Christ. And we put Berto, amen, before you.
Lord
in heaven, you created that body.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And we are not mindful of why this situation came upon him. But we're here, Lord Jesus, to pray and Father in heaven to intercede on his behalf.
Yes, Lord.
And to call that sickness out in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We shower and we sprinkle Berto with the blood of Jesus Christ. Lord in heaven, we saturate his bloodstream and his blood system with the blood of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
We reverse everything that the sugar diabetes has damaged. Hallelujah.
Yes,
I speak to those organs right now and I command them to receive strength in the name of
Jesus.
I speak to Berta's body right now.
Hallelujah.
And all the nerves, hallelujah, that may be damaged, hallelujah, that is causing discomfort and pain. I speak the peace of the Holy Spirit upon his very nerve endings right now, from his head to his toe, in the name of
Jesus.
I speak to his mind and his soul, and I come and I reverse and I remove everything in the Spirit, by the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus. In Berto's body. Hallelujah. Curse that sugar diabetes.
Yes.
I bring it down to normalcy in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I apply Isaiah 53, 4 and 5. Hallelujah.
That
says, by his stripes we were healed. We thank you for preparing that healing for us way back on Calvary, Lord. And we apply it to Berto's body.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus. We declare that he is healed in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
We break that spirit, hallelujah, of sickness upon his body.
Yes, Lord.
We break that spirit of infirmity upon his body right now. In the name of Jesus. And we declare that he is comforted, that he is healed, that he is at peace in the name of
Jesus.
We declare that from tonight he will sleep peacefully.
Yes.
And that when he goes, hallelujah, for his next checkup,
hallelujah,
the doctor, hallelujah, will be amazed.
Amen.
We declare that he is healed in Jesus' name, for he has already done it for Berto. In Jesus' name we pray and we declare. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Amen. Be blessed.
This is Choice Radio. Our time is gone. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Our time is gone. So we just want to thank God again for those of you who, hallelujah, there and listening. And Lord, even right now, we send forth your love and your word to those who are listening even right now. Father, those that are sick today in their bodies, we come against that spirit, that infirmity spirit, and we bind it tonight.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, we declare that hope has come to those who are listening.
Strength
we declare that strength has come.
Healing
we
has
declare
come.
That healing has come.
Wholeness.
Through your blood, we declare that wholeness has come.
Hey.
We declare tonight and we decree that prosperity has come in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, touch every home, touch every child, every boy, every girl in every home tonight. Let your peace reign through the season.
Amen.
That there'll be no incidents, there'll be no accidents. sustenance. Hallelujah, that there'll be enough food upon the tables. Lord, touch the hearts of men. Lord, that they will go, God, forth, and they will do what is right and acceptable unto you. Lord, we pray even right now for the unsaved members, hallelujah, of every household listening tonight, and we declare that they are saved through your blood, in the name of Jesus. So Lord, touch and heal and deliver, and we say thank you for doing it. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Even
and amen.
Right now, we just want to take this little minute again to say, if there is anyone who have not made Jesus Christ their Lord and Savior, hallelujah, we implore you that this is the day that the Lord has made for you. Do not wait. Amen. Enjoy your Christmas. Be merry in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And may the Lord be with you always. As he said, be blessed in Amen. Jesus' name.
People make and your house is not a home. You need someone. If you think life isn't fair and there's no one to share all those lonely days and nights when things don't seem to turn out right, and you want somebody to care, and you want somebody to be there, you need someone. So I give you Jesus. He's the peace that passes all understanding. I give you Jesus.
Jesus.
He's the perfect love that casts it out.
Choice Radio. Here we go. Here we go. Want inspiration, want to be lifted and refreshed. You gotta turn your radio.
Choice Radio, Choice Radio.
This music brings healing, brings joy and life to the depressed. Oh, gotta keep on.
Christmases be white.